Hi guys. In the previous video we talked about linear regression with one variable and we said that it consists in looking for a straight line that passes through the points representing the examples of the training database. In the case of our example, the area of the garden and the amount of water irrigation of this garden as coordinates. This line allows to predict the amount of irrigation water for a garden whose area is not included in the training database. More this line passes as close as possible to these points, the better the prediction will be. This straight line is called hypothesis and it is a function of variable x and has two parameters w0 and w1. These two parameters w can be modified in this analytical expression of this hypothesis so that the straight line will be the optimal one for prediction. If we zoom in on a few points of the graphical representation of the examples in the training database, we can notice that the distance di between a point and the hypothesis is equal to yi minus hxi squared. If we want to minimize all these distances di, we will minimize their sum. This minimization will be done with respect to their average distance, which is the reason why we divide by m, which is the number of examples in the training database. We also divide by 2 for simplifying some calculations that we will do in the following videos. This is how we define the cost function of variable w0 and w1. So if we summarize, finding the ideal hypothesis for predicting the quantity of irrigation water essentially consists in finding the omegas that minimize the cost function. It is easier to look for this minimum if the cost function is convex. Without going into too much mathematical detail, here we show you a two-variable convex function that has a single global minima. We now graphically represent the cost function Cw0W1. At first it seems that it is not a convex function, but if we represent it with filled contour plot, or with contour plot, we notice that it is indeed convex. We show here the relation between the position of a point on the curve of the cost function and the position of the hypothesis line. Each point of the curve provides a very particular position of this line. We notice also that each time we get closer to the minimum of the cost function, the area where the blue becomes more and more dark, the line of the hypothesis gets closer and closer to the ideal line. I now present to you now the Python notebook that I prepared to illustrate the plots presented in this video. In fact, this notebook is a continuation of the one of the previous video, so we're going to start its execution where we stopped last time. In this cell I have loaded the cost function. All the code in the next cell is used to plot this cost function in 3D. To check that the cost function is convex, I have plotted this cost function in three versions, 3D, filled contour plot, and contour plot. With the code in the last cell, you can visualize at the same time, on the right, the position of a point defined by the coordinates w0 and w1 on the curve of the cost function and the hypothesis produced using these two parameters w. You can try different values of the omegas in order to clearly capture the relation between the cost function and the hypothesis. As in the previous video, I attach the Python notebook that was used in this video. If you find that something is not clear or if you have a doubt on a specific point, do not hesitate to ask your questions and give your remarks in the comments. Thank you.